I once was well acquainted with a man named Joseph Dunne, and a very jolly man was he, fond of harmless fun. He courted young and married was when he was 21, and soon a respectable family had Mr. and Mrs. Dunne. For there was high Dunne and low Dunne, over Dunne and under Dunne, all the other Dunnes in and out did run. There was old Dunne and young Dunne, and young Dunne's younger son. Young Dunne would be a Dunne when old Dunne was Dunne. When Mrs. Dunne presented Dunne with their first bouncing son, they named him Patrick Seamus Cormac Duncan Dunne, but called him Cherry Bun. And when as thick as hops they come, and many more did run, said Mrs. Dunne to Mr. Dunne, more bread or will be done. For there was high Dunne and low Dunne, over Dunne and under Dunne, all the other Dunnes in and out did run. There was old Dunne and young Dunne, and young Dunne's younger son. Young Dunne would be a Dunne when old Dunne was Dunne. In the course of time, the eldest Dunne was nearly done undone. Just trying to feed his family kept him at a run, to try to keep their bellies full and a wife who weighed a ton. Well, any man who could do that, you'd have to say, well done. For there was high Dunne and low Dunne, over Dunne and under Dunne, all the other Dunnes in and out did run. There was old Dunne and young Dunne, and young Dunne's younger son. Young Dunne would be a Dunne when old Dunne was Dunne. Well, here's good luck to the eldest Dunne, also to the youngest Dunne. Let's hope the youngest Dunne can do as the eldest Dunne has done. For any chance to be a Dunne and a well done son of a Dunne, what's done says done should be well done, so well done, good old Dunne. For there was high Dunne and low Dunne, over Dunne and under Dunne, all the other Dunnes in and out did run. There was old Dunne and young Dunne, and young Dunne's younger son. Young Dunne would be a Dunne when old Dunne was Dunne. I'm done.